sequence is when you take a motif and then immediately after you then repeat it either lower or higher in pitch. And Beethoven's Fifth is a fantastic example of taking a motif and spinning it out time and time again using sequence. In fact, the whole first 50 seconds of this piece is all one motif span out in sequence, either played higher or lower. But this technique isn't exclusive to classical music. In fact, it's found in almost every style of music you can imagine, particularly pop music. So if I look at Clocks by Coldplay, you can see after the initial intro riff on piano, we get the vocal melody and we get this motif.
The lights go out and I can be saved.
And then immediately after, this same motif is repeated at a lower pitch.
The tides that I tried to swim against.
You will literally find this technique in almost any song you can think of, and it's because it's one of the most inherent musical ideas there is, repetition. I think Adam Neely puts it best when he says that
repetition legitimizes. Repetition legitimizes. Repetition legitimizes.
Repetition makes things sound more musical, it gives it more structure, and gives you a sense of anticipation of what's going to happen next. And what's more interesting than just repeating the same phrase? Well, it's repeating the same phrase at a lower or higher pitch. So let me show you another example, this time from Do Re Mi, written by Rodgers and Hammerstein, from The Sound of Music. So we start with this initial motif.
Do, a deer, a female deer. Re, a drop of golden sun.
Then we hear it again, but now move 2 degrees up the scale.
Mi, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run.
Then we get a second motif introduced.
So, a needle pulling thread.
And then that's repeated.
La, a note to follow.
And
so.
Then it's repeated again.
Tea, a drink.
And then we get a final concluding third motif
that
just to wrap the whole thing up. Let's look at a different song. Let's look at What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong. So it starts with this phrase to lead us in.
I see trees of green.
And then we get this motif, which is then repeated 1 degree down the scale.
I see them blue.
And then again.
For me and you.
And then we just hold on one note.
And I think to myself.
And we get a final phrase to wrap it off.
What a wonderful world.
Now, sequence isn't just for short motifs. It can also be used on longer phrases. Here with the Game of Thrones theme, we start with this phrase. And then the phrase is repeated down 1 degree of the scale. You may have also noticed that when that phrase was repeated, there was a small variation at the end. And that is quite common when using sequence to put small variations in the motif. So here with Get Lucky, we get a simple motif to start the chorus, which is then repeated, and then repeated one step down the scale. And finally moved another step down and given a small variation at the end. So sequence really does appear in any style you can think of. Here's a couple examples from very contrasting styles. Let's look at one more example. Let's look at ABBA's Knowing Me, Knowing You. So Knowing Me, Knowing You begins with a simple motif, and then that motif's repeated down, and then moved back up again, but this time we've got a different chord behind it, so it sounds a little bit different. And then those 4 bars are repeated. And then we get a new phrase. And then that phrase gets moved down 1 degree. So basically, sequence is just one of the many tools that a songwriter has to take a motif, which is basically just a small melodic segment, a small melodic idea, and to then develop it to spin it out into a fully fledged melody. And using a technique like sequence to build from a small motif to a greater melody makes the melody feel cohesive and makes it feel like it belongs together rather than just a collection of random notes. So my hope is that now, when you listen to music, you're going to find sequence everywhere. Now, granted, it's not the only way to spin a motif out, but it's an incredibly common technique. So it doesn't matter what the style of music is, listen out and see if you can find that the melodies that you've always known and loved are actually built using sequence.
Well, the answer is repetition. Either exact repetition or a slightly altered repetition within the theme itself. It's that repetition that makes the melody stick in your mind. And it's the melodies that stick in your mind that are likely to please you the most. Popular songwriters know this, and that's why they repeat their phrases so often. But let's take, for one example, our good old standby, Beethoven's Fifth. Here, one, on your mark. Two, get set. Three, go.